So oxytocin is sometimes called the love molecule or the love hormone. And so we showed many years ago that touch releases oxytocin. So as an experiment on myself, because I'm an introvert and I like my private time, I thought, I wonder if people would connect better to me if I started hugging everybody. Just, I don't know, I'm always doing experiments on myself. There's this saying in science that all research is me search. So maybe I spent all this time studying oxytocin because I had some shortcomings in my own life. Nevertheless, I found that if I told people, hey, I hug everybody, people immediately connected better to me. They opened up. The conversations were richer. The relationships developed much more rapidly. And so the students in my lab started giving me the nickname Dr. Love, which I thought was very funny. Nah, whatever. And then a couple years ago, I had a reporter from Fast Company come out to do a story on me, which is always a very strange thing. I'm really not sure what people want to do. I put him in a couple of experiments, took his blood. Anyway, before he left, he said, hey, I'm the oxytocin guy. I hug everybody. I'm going to give you a hug before you leave. And then he titles his article, Introducing Dr. Love. I thought, oh my gosh, I'm a serious guy. You guys know this. I'm a serious scientist. I can't have these funny nicknames. And I thought, what a gift this reporter has given to me. Right? What better thing can I do in my life than to encourage people to be loving towards each other? So love is a part of our biology. We're meant to care and love for the people around us. So I want to encourage you to tell the people around you that you love them. And if I can give you a prescription, I recommend 8 hugs a day. Give it a try. You can be the person who initiates this cycle of caring, of empathy, by just giving someone the gift of oxytocin release after a hug.